to reduce the given input string to the starting symbol. At each reduction step, a substring of input matching to the right side of the production rule is replaced by non-terminal. Okay, so at the left side of that production rule, so non-terminal at the left side of the production rule is nothing but the head. Okay, so if the substituting is chosen correctly, the rightmost derivation of the string is created in the reverse order. Okay, so rightmost derivation, you can see, you know, this is the start symbol and this is the input string. So here you can see the direction. Okay, so by doing the rightmost derivation, we reach to this to this. Okay, now shift reduce parsing example. So, you can see one grammar is given here and input string is given here. Okay, so this red color A is reduced first by this capital A, right? Then small a capital A is reduced by this capital A. Then this capital B is reduced by B using B to B, this production rule, right? Then A B B can be reduced using this production rule and we get S. So this is what the reduction is. Okay, and if you write it in the formal form, how we write the reduction and derivations, in this case reduction, you can write it like this. Okay, now show the right sentinel forms for each reduction. How do we know which substring to be replaced at each reduction step? So this is the big question here, and for that reason we need the parsing algorithm. The parsing algorithm helps us to, you know which substring to be replaced at each reduction step. Who will tell us? The parsing algorithm. Okay, so a shift reduce parser handles and writes sentinel forms. If you see here another example, grammar is given. How you can do it, the derivation is given for a given string id plus id into id. Okay, so how we maintain this right sentinel form and reducing production, we just do like this: id plus id in multiplication id. Okay, then we read it from left to right, you get this id first, and we have a production rule that is f to id, right? So we replace this by a plus id get, and this, right? Then we have t to f, we have all, you know, this production rule. So this we already know what you need to do. We have to do this f to reduce to t plus id multiplication id. Then this t can be reduced to e even, right? We have production rule e to t. So if we do that, we can do this plus id multiplication id, right? Next, this e is not reducible anymore. So e plus is also not reducible. So we get this id, we take this id, okay? And we can reduce it by f to id, right? So we get t plus id multiplication id, okay? Sorry, t plus f multiplication id. This id is reduced, right? Then, e plus f cannot be, reduced, right? a plus f or f multiplication individually or the pairs cannot be reduced. So we have to consider this id. So again we consider this f can be reduced, right? So t to f we have. Okay, so what we can do, e plus t multiplication id. Okay, now if we reduce this t to, you know, like this here we had done, then we will not be able to finish this, so we will not reduce this t. Now, you know, why we are taking this decision and how do we know, right? How do we know that if we reduce this t here, we are going to make an error, right? So how do we know this? That question will be answered, or you know, that will be maintained by the parsing algorithm. We'll see later. So at for the time being, what we will do, we will take this id, consider this id, and as in a right sentinel form, and we'll reduce this by f to id. So in our hand it will be e plus t multiplication f, right? Now t multiplication f together can be reduced by t to t multiplication f. We have this production rule here. Okay, so what we will have, e plus t. Now e plus t can be reduced using this production rule, that is e to e plus t. Okay, so which will give us e. Now e is the starting symbol of the grammar, and we reach to the root, which is, and the root is having the start symbol of the grammar, so you can say it is successful. So Handel's so here I think you understood what are the part are treated as Handel, what time. So most of them I have underlined. Okay, so like this. So this is Handel here. Okay. Now, shift reduce parsing use of stack. So I had told you that there will be a stack later, right? So how to maintain the stack here? So the same thing what we was doing, you know, for the given grammar and this production rule, we had already, you know, produced parse tree. But if we want to use the stack right now, then what we'll do, we will create a table like this. Okay, we will maintain a stack here. And we will keep the inputs here. And whatever action we will take, we will maintain here. Okay. So initially, when you are using stack, initially, we are going to put a dollar sign inside the stack. Okay. And we will also augment the input with a dollar sign. Okay, so that we can stop when we will reach at the end of the input string. Okay, so first action is a shift action. Okay, so why you are choosing a shift action here? Because first, let me tell you what happens in shift. When we do a shift action, we basically move one symbol from the input to stack. Okay, this is what happens in shift. Okay, so in this, and when we reduce from the stack. Now, at the initial condition in the stack, there is nothing, so we can't reduce anything. So what we have to do, we have to shift something from the input to stack. So we are shifting it, and so our stack will become like this, dollar id, the first id I have shifted. Okay, so in input we will remain only star and id 2 and dollar. Now in the stack we have id. Okay, we have id which can be reduced by f to ID. So we got a right sentinel form or handle here in the stack. So we do this reduction. Okay. So dollar, we do the reduction ID to F. What we will have in our hand as input, the same thing, right? So in the stack we have F. Now again, F is a right sentinel form for the production rule T to F, right? So again, we can do a reduction. This F will be replaced by T, and in our input star ID 2 and dollar will be there, right? So right now, what action we have to take? We have to do a shift option, right? Now the same question can come in your mind. Then even this T was reducible by this production rule E to T. Now why we are not doing that? Instead of doing this, we are going for a shift action. So that again, the same answer I'm giving you, that it will be decided by the parse table. When we will create the parse table, we will understand this. Okay. So if we do a shift here, then one symbol will be shifted from the input to the stack. Now here, star is shifted and ID 2 will remain here and dollar will remain here. Now this star, T star is not reducible, right? So we have to take another shift operation here. So that this ID can be shifted here in the stack. So in the stack, it will be T star ID 2. Okay. And in input symbol, there will be only dollar remaining. Now at this moment, we can reduce this ID by using F to ID. So that we will have in the stack dollar T asterisk F. Okay, and in input there is only dollar remaining. Okay, now T asterisk F can be reduced. Okay, so here you can write reduce operation. So here also we can have a reduce operation, that is using this rule T to T multiplication F. Okay, so we'll have in the stack, stack will just pop out all these three things and push this T here. Okay, and this dollar is already here. Okay. So at this moment, what can happen? What action can we take at this moment? Only T is there in the stack, so we have a production rule E to T. So again, reduce. Okay, so what will happen here? E will come here, dollar will come here. Okay, so what is the action we can take? So here, when you are using stack, we'll stop when in the stack we will have only dollar and the starting symbol E, a root starting symbol of the grammar E. Only these two symbols are there in the stack, or in the input, only one symbol is there, that is the dollar. Okay, then we will say it is accepted and we'll stop doing this derivation. Okay, now one thing again you can notice here, this reduce actions, if you just follow, you can draw that derivation tree or parse tree as well. Okay, so if I just remove this side, okay, and here, if you can, what we had ID multiplication ID. So what was the first reduction? F to ID. So do this. Okay. Next reduction was T to F. Do this. Next was F to ID. So here it will happen. Next was T to T into F. T to T into F. Next was E to T. So you can see only this reduction operations, if we just follow the sequence of reduction in bottom-up manner, then we can just produce the required parts tree. Okay, so this is how the parts tree can be generated using shift-reduce parsing technique. Okay, now a stack implementation of shift-reduce parsing, there are four possible action shift-reduce parser actions. One is shift, the next input symbol is shifted onto the top of the stack, we know it. Reduce, it replaces the handle on the top of the stack by a non-terminal. So see, it chose the handle on the top of the stack, right? So here one thing we need to understand, that it is not a single symbol from the stack of the stack, top of the stack. It can be multi-symbol handle from the top of the stack. Okay, what is accept? Successful completion of the parsing, and error, parser discovers a syntax error and calls the error recovery routine. So initial stack just contains only the end mark and dollar symbol, and the end of the input string is marked by end mark dollar symbol. So we have already seen all these things and we have done it, right? So here you can see the action. So draw the parse tree using this. I have already shown you what you have to do. You have to just follow the reduce actions, right? So here, if you see, here the string is different, so we can do it. What we have, ID plus ID multiplication ID. So first reduction is F to ID. So do this. Next reduction action is T to F. Do it. Next reduction is E to T. So do this, then shift, shift, again, we have a reduction here, F to ID. So we do it here, okay, then T to F, so this F is reduced to T. Next reduction option is here, F to ID, so do this. Then we have T to reduction, which is T to T multiplication F. So we can do this, T to T multiplication F. Next is E to E plus T, right? So E to E plus T. So we reset the root, and which is start symbol of the string. And here you can see the condition for accept is satisfying. So it is accepted and it is completed successfully, right? Now, conflicts during shift reduce parsing. So there are context-free grammars for which shift reduce parsing cannot be used. Okay, stack contains contents can, and the next input symbol may not be decide the action. Shift reduce conflict happens. So either make a shift operation or a reduction operation are conflicting together. So you have both the options, then which option to choose, right? So the parser cannot decide which of the several reduction to make. That is what called reduce conflict. So there is two kind of conflict. One is shift reduce conflict and another is reduce conflict, right? So in shape reduced parser cannot be used for a grammar. That grammar is called as non-LR K grammar. Okay, so you have to know this, that in LR, this LRK means that this L is left to right scanning of the input. This R is the rightmost derivation, and the K is the K number of look ahead. That means how many symbols we can see to take a decision at the time of doing the parsing. So an ambiguous grammar can never be LR grammar again. So in previously also we have seen that ambiguous grammar cannot be LL grammar at the time of top down parsing. Now at the time of LR also you are seeing the same thing. Ambiguous grammar can never be a LR grammar. Okay. Now shift reduced parser, if you see, there are two main categories of shift reduced parser. One is operator precedence parser, that is simple, but only small class of grammar is there for this, because only grammar which involves an arithmetic operators can be used, or other kind of operators can also be comes under this set. Okay, and LR parser that covers wide range of grammar, different LR parsers are like SLR parser, simple LR parser is called SLR parser. Then LR parser, the most general LR parser, and LR parser, intermediate LR parser, or look ahead LR parser is called as LR parser. Now SLR, LR, and LR work in same procedure. Okay, their procedure of working are same, only their parsing table are different. Okay, but their parsing algorithms are same, only the tables are different. Now if you see the relation among these different grammars, you will see at the topmost it is biggest set is the CFG, then context free grammars. Now few context free grammar can be handled by simple LR, normal LR parser. Okay, this is most general LR parser. Okay, and a subset of LR can become LR parser, and a subset of LR can be SLR, can be grammar. Okay, so SLR grammar means these grammars can be implemented using